important criteria to identify the process, it as spontaneous or non-spontaneous, reversible. So to know the value of the del G and the value of del A, already we have discussed. And after that, we have discussed the physical significance of the del G and del A. And next, we have discussed the changes of Gibbs free energy and changes of Helmholtz free energy with temperature, changing of temperature. That is known as the Gibbs-Helmholtz equation. Changes of Gibbs energy, Gibbs free energy, and changes of Helmholtz free energy with changing temperature, that is known as the Gibbs-Helmholtz equation. Probably last day already we have started and completed the Gibbs-Helmholtz equation also, right? So almost completed the thermodynamics part. Now, so now today we will discuss shortly about the Maxwell relationship. Maxwell relationship, to discuss the Maxwell relationship, see, so there are four relationships as the known of the Maxwell relationship. All are the important to derive the different relationship also in our thermodynamics. So that is the procedure. So suppose considering the G, Gibbs free energy, ultimately we have got the relationship dG is equal to VdP minus sdT. I'm telling again, so considering G, ultimately we are getting G is equal to H minus TS, and next dG is equal to dU, and H is equal to U plus PB. So G is equal to U plus PB minus TS, and next dG is equal to VdP minus sdT. Yes?
Someone are waiting, sir.
So, always some students are waiting. What I do? To join them, I'll go back again with Roshan Singh. So G is equal to U plus PB minus TDS and TS, and you know that at constant previously, so when we have discussed the Gibbs free energy, ultimately we have got the relationship dG is equal to VdP minus sdT. Similarly, from the Helmholtz free energy, dA is equal to minus PdB minus sdT. So considering this relationship, actually we know G, A, U, H, all are the state function. All are the state function. So if all are the state function, so the we can say that this is following the exact differential or the perfect differential. So double derivative, that will be the shape. So considering this concept, again, H is equal to U plus PV, and we have got the relationship dH is equal to TdS plus VdP, and dU is equal to TdS minus PdP. So write the four relationship first. I'm telling you, write four relationship. One, dG is equal to VdP minus sdT. Second, dA is equal to minus PdB minus sdT. So we can derive it from this also. Next, third, dA is equal to TdS plus VdP. And last, dU is equal to changes of internal energy, TdS minus PdB. All are the state function. H, U, G, A, all are the state function. So state function means it is following that. So just I have written here also, dG is equal to this, dA is equal to this, dU is equal to this, dH is equal to this. So considering it, so there is one Maxwell experiment also. We are not discussing that. Full differential, that will be the shape. So how it will be derived? I am telling again, if dG is equal to VdP minus sdT, so we can write that del V by del T at constant P is equal to minus del S by del P at constant T. I am telling again, you can write in your copy and see it.
Okay. Some students are waiting.
Wait, let them wait. Del V by del T, del V by del T at constant P is equal to minus del S by del P at constant T. So if you have understood how we are writing it, So we can write another three expression as the Maxwell relationship. Just I am repeating now. Del V by del T. Del V by del T at constant P is equal to the minus minus, keep it, minus del S by del P at constant T. So if you have understood how we have written the Maxwell relationship considering this relation, so now I am telling you, so try to write considering this relationship also, what will be the Maxwell relationship, which is dA is equal to minus PdB minus ST. Like, minus PdB, first write in your copy, dA is equal to minus PdB minus SDT. Minus PdB minus ST. Now, try to what will be the Maxwell relation. And I was right. Someday nobody knows. Who has written the relationship? D A G equal to minus P D B minus S D T. Take me home where I belong. I can. Have you written it?
Yes.
Hello?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
tell
sir.
Me. Tell me. Anyone? D A is equal to minus P D B minus S D T. So considering the exact differential, or it is following the perfect differential, so that double derivative will be same. So what will be the relationship as the Maxwell relationship? Just like the previous one. So I am telling again, you can compare with your answer also. Again, minus del P by del T at constant V is equal to minus del S by del V at constant T.
One.
Del P minus
okay. See.
Del P by del T at constant V is equal to minus del S by del V at constant T. So both sides negative, negative will be cancelled. So you can write only the del P by del T at constant V is equal to del S by del V at constant T. Is it right to your answer? Have you checked? Have you compared with your answer what you have written? Hello? Am I audible or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So have you checked with your answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So write the next one. D is equal to TDS minus PDB. 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 What will be the answer? Have you written anyone? Tell me.
Sir, del T by del V. Sir, del T by del V at constant S. Minus is equals to minus del P by del S at constant V.
Yes, right. Good. So write the next expression also. D A is equal to T D S plus V D P. D A is equal to T D S plus V D P. VH is equal to TDS plus VDP. Who will give the answer?
So del T by del P at constant S is equal to del P by del S at constant P.
So all of you have understood or not? So how we are determining the Maxwell relationship? Very simple. So equalizing the double differentiation. So that means all the relationship G, A, U, H, all are the state function. It is following the differences, also the exact differential. It is following the perfect differential. So we have written it, and these are known as the, just you have written, that is same. These are known as the Maxwell equation, Maxwell relationship. Why it is important? Actually, you see that in different derivation in our thermodynamics, suppose the derivations also in terms of P and S or P and V. So when it is P and V, so how it will be converted into the normal two terms. So in that time, so we are using it also. We are using it. So del S by del P at constant is equal to this. Again, del S by del V at constant is equal to this. That means at isothermal process, del S by del P by del S by del P at constant T, if you get one value, so that will be equalized with this also. That is not at the isothermal process, but it will be equalized with it. So in this way, we are deriving, we are calculating, we are solving different problems also in thermodynamics. So these are very helpful, Maxwell relationship. So after that, Clausius-Clapeyron equation, so I will not discuss details about it also. So too much already we have discussed in our thermodynamics. Clausius-Clapeyron equation, just only know that that is applicable for the phase transformation. Phase transformation means suppose solid to liquid, liquid to gaseous. So there is an equilibrium in between the solid liquid, there is an equilibrium in between the liquid gaseous also. In that case, so the phase transformation from one phase to another phase, so we are using the Clausius-Clapeyron equation. So ultimately in the Clausius-Clapeyron equation, we have developed this relationship that will be hectic for you also. So I decided that I will not discuss details here. So only dP by dt for the as the Clausius-Clapeyron equation. So vaporization of liquid and dP by dt, so changes of pressure with temperature, that will be latent heat, that is you know also by T and del T. That is the one important expression as the latent heat, sorry, Clausius-Clapeyron equation. Okay. So now we will not discuss details about the Clausius-Clapeyron equation. The next part, we will start to discuss the electrochemistry. Just I am giving the introduction today, so next day we will start. And before starting the electrochemistry, I have given one assignment also. So probably you know, we will give the first assessment marks. So we are trying to conduct one exam. If it is possible, that is good. Before the giving the first assessment mark. Otherwise, next day, but today also I have taken that type of test. Next day means tomorrow, Wednesday, so Thursday. Next day, we have the class. In that class, I will ask some MCQ. So I will ask the particular students. I will indicate the name and roll number also. I will ask the particular students. So he or she will unmute their video and audio also, and he or she will give the answer. On the basis of your attendance, on the basis of your performance, so we will give the marks. Is it clear to everybody? So you will study the thermodynamics. So probably you are studying. I hope you are studying also. This is the another known chapter. Already we have read in your 10 plus 2 level. So my plan is that next day, next Thursday, I will ask some question to the particular students. So the students will unmute their video and audio also. He or she will give the answer, will try the answer. Right. So is it clear to everybody? So all of you who are present today, who are not present today, so if possible, you will convey the message also next day, Thursday, first, before studying the next topic, electrochemistry, I will ask the question. Okay, on the basis of your performance, so I will give the answer. Right. So next, just I am giving today the introduction. So next day I will start. Electrochemistry. What is this? What is electrochemistry? What will be the discussion under the electrochemistry? What do you mean by the electrochemistry? What do you mean by the Siddharth Singh? Siddharth, hello, hello, Siddharth.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I don't know till date we have not changed your profile. That is the first question. Every day I am observing that you are joining without your profile photo. If you have the problem, I told you that you are the IT student, sir. Why you are facing the problem? You can ask to your friends also. Can ask to your friends how you will change it. Is it clear?
Okay, sir.
And why you are joining after 25 minutes? That is the time to leave from the class. Why are you joining after 25 minutes? You are doing the online classes, but you are joining after 20 minutes, after 25 minutes. Do you know when the physical class will start? So after 2-3 minutes, you will not be allowed in the class also. No teacher will allow you. So next, last day also, yesterday also, I have seen. You have joined after 10-15 minutes. So you are joining only to take the attendance. Siddharth?
No, sir.
So, kya hua, well? So tell me, what will be the discuss under the electrochemistry part? What will be the aim, or what is the aim or objective of the electrochemistry? What will be discussed under electrochemistry?
Sir, relationship.
Rohit, unmute your mic. Lisa.
Sir, electrochemistry is a basic study of relation between electrical energy and chemical energy.
Electrical energy and chemical energy.
Yes, sir.
Electrical energy and chemical energy. So that relationship will be discussed under the electrochemistry. So relationship in between electrical energy and chemical energy. Okay. And another things we can say that that means you are trying to say that in the electrochemistry part. So electrical energy will convert into the chemical energy, or chemical energy will convert into the electrical energy. So considering the both principle, we can construct the electrochemical cell. Am I right? Using the both principle, where the once the electrical energy converted into the chemical energy, or the chemical energy is converting the electrical energy. So considering the both principle, we can construct the electrochemical cell. So there are two types of electrons, obviously on the basis of principle. So that is also known as the storage cell. So in electrochemistry part, first we will discuss the different principle in the electrochemistry, construction of the electrochemical cell, and the last uses of the electrochemical cell. First we will discuss the different principle. Principle means we will discuss that how the thermodynamics is related with the electrochemistry. We will discuss that how the electrochemical potential value will help to determine the most important terms in the thermodynamics, like changes of entropy, changes of Gibbs free energy, changes of age also, or the heat content value. And we know that in thermodynamics, if we know the del H value, del S value, del G value, we can identify the process is spontaneous or not. With the help of electrode potential value, we can determine the del G, the del S, and del H value. That will be also discussed in the first part. Okay. And next we'll discuss, so there are so many principles also there. Next we'll discuss details about the non-stipulation, how the non-stipulation is useful to determine the unknown electrode potential value. Okay, so to determine the unknown electrode potential value, we'll discuss about the single electrode half cell. And at the end, we'll discuss the uses, application of the storage cell. Application of the electrochemical cell as the storage cell also. So all are known, probably you have did also in your 10 plus 2 level. So we'll discuss again, but I am telling again before discussing it, next day I will ask MCQ and your, I'm telling again, your audio and video will be open at that time if we ask the particular students and you will give the answer. Okay. So today is not known, next Thursday I will take the test in this way. So now we back in. Rule number one.
Present, sir.
Two. Rule number two, three, four, five,